you don't need a Lamborghini to go to the grocery store, or you have to need something better than tractor to go to grocery store. It is important to find the proper tools for proper usage. So my name is Andriy Palasyuk, and I am a scientist too at Ames Lab. The gap magnet problem is essentially a strength problem, because if you talk about four present commercially available magnets, you can easily separate them into two groups. For example, low performing group and high performing group. The gap between them is 10 megagauss or stead. So the low performing group is from 0 to 10, and the high performing group is starting from 20 and going up to 60 megagauss or stead. So the gap exists between 10 and 20 megagauss or stead. But this gap creates other gaps. For example, gap between niche market and the mass market of permanent magnets. And because those who are like Alnico or Samarium Cobalt, they found themselves in niche market. Only ferrites, which are very mediocre performing but very cheap, they are in the mass market, as well as those strong but very expensive, they are also in the mass market. So there is a huge need to populate the space between, for example, ferrites and neodymium iron borides. And magnet developer project, where I am a PI at this moment, is a multi-pronged approach, which includes experimental part in Ames, which includes a theory part in Oak Ridge, and which includes database part in UC Davis. So this is also multi-institutional effort. And we are trying to make a commercial product. This is where we work with our industry partner. It's a US manufacturer, Bunting Dubois, and they are trying to make a bonded magnet, which will be 30%, 20 to 30% better than sintered ferrites. Using cerium makes materials produced from with cerium supply independent, or less supply dependent. To show you the potential of this material, we have a S-cast piece of 50 grams, which is basically holding 2.5 kilograms of steel, I guess, or iron, cast iron. So you see it's already pulling 50 times, and I think we have pieces which will pull 100 times of its mass. But on the smaller scale, we believe that this should be pulling 450 times of its weight if it's fully optimized. The MPC is a great organization to start scaling up.
MPC maintains expertise and equipment so that we can enable other people's research. Typically, we're known for the ultra-high purity rare earths that we can supply. In the case for the Andriy's magnet project, we're using commercial grade rare earth elements and other elements to make these alloys, crush the materials after we've made the alloys to the right particle size, and safely supply those to the project.
And we have a small dream and a big dream. A small dream would be a successful realization of TCF project, meaning that we produce bonded magnet using our composition with our Bunting Dubois industry partner, and we successfully reach our objectives on that project, which will be 30% better than the hard ferrite and the sintered ferrite. But the big dream is, in fact, developing 20 megagauss or stead, one step castable cerium magnet, which will be also cobalt lean.